Well, you know, let that secret out of the back. I believe that you were making crap.
It's really the fact that I get to get tons of
sleep. I'm out.
You know, the only days of the paper actually is sleeping on the show. It's pretty awesome.
It is pretty awesome. It's about all 2 weeks at most. Yeah.
So good to see each and every one of you, and thank you, choir. It's a delight to have that choir. I know you agree with me. So this is our time for greetings and announcements. So if you have an announcement, there are microphones that can be passed out, and I see someone in the back that has an announcement. Paula.
Today is Pastor Day, so we want to wish our pastor good luck and thank you for everything he does here at the church. Good morning. Three things this morning. Friday's lunch will be in Bement this week at the nursing home at 11:30. The deacons are getting ready to write our holiday gift certificates next month. If you would like to contribute to the deacons fund, you can put your check in the offering plate or leave it in the office by November 5th. And please put deacons fund in the memo. And last, I'll be getting tickets for the Vesper service. It is on Sunday, December 3rd of this year at 2:00 in the afternoon. If you would like to go, please let me know by November 1st. Tickets this year are $12. There's a sign-up sheet in the back of the church for the Presbyterian Women's Fall Luncheon. It will be on Friday, October 20th at 12:00. Your lunch is provided, and we'll have a guest speaker from Pike County Faith in Action services for seniors. Hope you can come.
I apologize for the length of this announcement. In case you're wondering why I have all my family here today, it's because we went to Kimmerer Village on Friday. Kimmerer has been one of the congregation's mission projects for over 65 years that I'm aware of. And the major mission, which now includes Camp Carew, with my wife Marie and myself, for over 50 years. In case you do not see all seven of us here today,
fair and straight from your ways, like lost sheep, we have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended.
Even if we make bad choices, God does not give up on us. So, I will say this again, God does not give up on us. Now, that doesn't mean that we should try to act like Timmy or try to be like the people in the story. Or, sorry, that's the example that I have written down. I forgot to put Brian. So, Brian. Brian, where we act like chatters and don't try to change our behavior. The reason we don't act like that.